But for now, there is a story that we had highlighted earlier on in the bulletin, and we now want to link up with our team, Otieno, who is now joining us live from Nairobi West, where we will sample reactions of motorists over the ruling of the Court of Appeal that the use of Alco-Blow to arrest drunk drivers is actually illegal. This, however, does not mean that motorists are off the hook, as the NTSA maintains that it is still illegal for motorists to drive while they are drunk. Well, team, thank you so much for joining us here on Friday Briefing. Very interesting developments we've had today, and I can tell that wherever you are, it's a buzz of activities. So what are people saying about this move by the court?
Well, Betty, I can tell you for sure people are making merry following that Court of Appeal directive that has temporarily suspended the use of Alco-Blow. I'm at one of the local joints here in Nairobi West, and I can tell you people are really happy with that particular directive. I'm going to be speaking to a few of them just to find out what the reason for their excitement is in particular. I'm joined by one of the revelers here. Hello, sir. Maybe you could begin by telling us your name and your reactions to that Court of Appeal directive suspending it.
Charles Ososo. I'm so happy. I'm so happy to an extent that the Kenyanese government that have realized they are losing revenue. Revenue collection, because they have been losing money by arresting TNA, they have been arresting innocent people from wanatoa kwa pombe, wanakunywa pombe, wanatoa kukaa na marafiki. Wanatoa kukaa na marafiki. No, anashikwa. Pombe, kama tunge kuwa na pombe, Kenya Brewery imeandika wafanyakazi wangapi? Kenya Brewery imeandika wafanyakazi wangapi? Hawa ni wasasi, wanasomesha watoto wangapi? Na wanaelea watoto wangapi? Pombe, vile mimi natumia, sio vile mtu mwingine anatumia.
All right. Asante sana. Maybe labda we could get opinions from other people as well in regards to this particular reaction for suspending of the Alco-Blow. I see another reveler here. Thank you so much for talking to KTN News. Begin by telling us your name, and do you support that Court of Appeal directive?
Yes, my name is Salim. I really don't support Alco-Blow. They have been there to harass Kenyans. The reason why we drink, we just relieve ourselves after hard work, and Alco-Blow cannot deny us the chance to relieve ourselves and enjoy ourselves. Alco-Blow has been there to just take our money, and they should be scrapped away. Let the government deserve another way of just helping Kenyans not to have accidents. Alco-Blow should be scrapped completely out of order. They have been just there to scrap, to harass Kenyans. Nothing else. Alco-Blow with some of the police officers, they have been there to take our money in the name of helping to reduce accidents. But remember, before Alco-Blow, we have been driving and we have been drinking. Alco-Blow has not helped anything. Let the government deserve another way of reducing accidents after drinking.
Yes. All right, thank you so much for speaking to us. I mean, this is a gadget that is meant to protect both motorists and pedestrians on the road. So much excitement that it's being taken off the streets. Perhaps I could ask this gentleman here, why such great opposition to a gadget that is meant to protect Kenyans on the road?
Yeah, my name is Engineer Chris Mugwanga. Engineer Chris Mugwanga is a honorable, has aspired for many seats, but this is not invaluable. We want to talk really to the topic. Alco-Blow is a disaster to our people. It's a disaster because we cannot allow ourselves to spend money to police court, to police and court. This is a situation that we have been drinking, we have been giving people tips, people have been benefiting out of us. Nowadays, we have reduced their budget because of Alco-Blow. Since that a drunkard man must have a concubine. And a concubine is not that you have a woman.
All right, sir. It's a bit of a deviation. Thank you so much for speaking to KTN News. I'll get maybe one more, Betty, just to get a final reaction in regards to the people's moods, in regards to that particular court directive. I'll try and walk over to this particular table here. As you can imagine, people are making merry. It's a Friday evening. Sir, perhaps my question to you would be, it's not the first time we're seeing the courts suspend the use of Alco-Blow. It has been suspended before and then brought back. Are you worried that this particular court directive may not last and sooner or later the Alco-Blow will be back on the Kenyan roads?
The law, that law is was implemented in a hurry. What I would suggest, legislators should go to other countries that have implemented this law. Like in the UK, you go to the Middle East and borrow a leaf from them. The problem with our system, it's so draconian. It's a very bad system because we are normally handled in a very bad way. We service what other countries do. So the people should sit down, more so the legislators, and probably implement the system in a better way. You can imagine being dragged into a Land Rover, like a criminal case. You can imagine your car being towed away and you're being told to pay $10,000 the next day. You can imagine being locked in a cell as if you have killed somebody. Number two, I think our road accidents are not a cause of, the BI is not the main cause of our problems. Look at it nowadays in Nairobi. Accidents are found along Mombasa Road, and the people involved are not even drunk. We need to have proper road signs, and the roads must also be in order. Lastly, I have a feeling that we are trying to get into business that we don't understand. NTSA should concentrate on safety measures, not harassing motorists. At the same time, taking BI is also contributing so much to the economy. It has been there for years, and I don't think it's a big problem. Enda kwa Juma.
All right. Thank you so much for speaking to KTN News. Of course, that's just some of reactions from the revelers here who are obviously so excited that Alco-Blow will not be on the roads, at least temporarily. So that means then that the National Transport and Safety Authority will have to come up with new mechanisms or go back to the traditional ones of determining whether a motorist is drunk or not. But of course, we can confirm to you here that indeed the National Transport and Safety Authority is conducting an operation tonight across most of the major roads in the country, and they have insisted, despite that court directive, they are going to be arresting motorists who are found to be drinking while under the influence of alcohol. So from here in Nairobi West, people are making merry. At one point, even they were actually applauding that particular directive, and we spoke to others who say that they're going to be toasting tonight towards that quote-unquote victory against the Alco-Blow. So from Nairobi West here in Nairobi, Betty, I hand it back to you in studio.
Tim, just before I let you go, if you can hear me, as you mentioned, that NTSA has still maintained that, you know, they will be out looking for drunk drivers. So do we know what methods now they will be using now that they cannot use the Alco-Blow?
I think, Betty, they may now have to go back to traditional methods of... I'm finding it hard to describe it. Maybe tell you to walk in a line, for example, or tell you maybe to put your hands up with one leg up and see whether you can be able to balance for quite a while. And then they'll have to go back to those basically traditional methods of scrutinizing drivers to find out whether they are under the influence. But remember, Betty, this particular machine had been... made in such a way that it would allow room for maybe one bottle of drink.
Yes.
It would not allow for excessive drinking.
Right.
So the traditional methods of trying to determine whether a driver is drunk may not really go a long way in determining whether the number of bottles that one has taken. But nonetheless, the intent is meant to ensure that people are safe on the roads. Indeed, the statistics within themselves are not that good. Just this year alone, in February, I remember I did a story on road fatalities, and about 150 people had already died by week six. And most of these deaths had been attributed to driving errors. Now, indeed, those statistics don't clearly point out to alcoholism or being found to drive under the influence of alcohol, but nonetheless, NTSA have been worried that that may be one of the major contributors. So does going back to traditional methods of lift your hand up, walk in a straight line, or hold your breath for a certain time, will it go a long way in determining how guilty or innocent one is if one is captured? Perhaps that will be the point of argument if this particular petition goes to the Supreme Court. Remember, it's just the Court of Appeal that has issued this directive. There is still room to go to the highest court in the land to appeal that particular directive, Betty.
Okay, Tim, finally, my final question. Those drivers, do they know that NTSA is still on the lookout? Because they obviously seem to be having a good time, but NTSA says that they're still on it.
To be honest, at the moment, they don't seem the least bothered by the fact that there's still an operation ongoing. They're making merry, despite the rain, but remember, it has been raining in Nairobi, but that hasn't dampened any of their moods or any of their spirits, and they are, of course, insisting that they're going to be making merry. Perhaps they'll sort themselves out in regards to how they are going to be going back home, but for now, they are still going to be making merry, having fun. They'll see how they get back home. And of course, we do hope that they get back home safely, because the number of lives lost on the roads is alarming at the moment, Betty.
All right. Thank you very much, Tim Muthiotieno. They're doing a great job in Nairobi West. You should also get home safely. And of course, quite a number of motorists, as you've seen, very happy with that Court of Appeal directive that now makes the Alco-Blow gadget illegal. All right, so we're about to wrap up things here on Friday Briefing, but remember, we had our big question, and we had asked you if the announcement of the presidential poll results in the polling station will actually ensure credibility of the process and confidence in the process. And we've gotten quite an overwhelming feedback in terms of messages and tweets, and 68% of you say yes, that it will indeed ensure that there's credibility in the whole process. 18% say no, and then also 14% say that they're really not sure if this is going to be the silver bullet in this, which is one of the issues really that has been a controversial one in previous elections, the presidential results. All right, so we're about to wrap up things. I'll ask you to stand.
Yes.
Remember that we had our guest anchor in studio. I don't know what you have to say about our brothers or almost fathers there who are having a good time now that Alco-Blow is off the roads.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, you know, and I don't think, I think it's good for people to drive when they're safe.
Right.
And I don't think alcohol is one of those chemicals that make you safe when you're driving.
Yeah.
Of course, there should be safer methods.
Yes.
I think it's something has to be done, because there are a number of people losing their lives.
Yeah. And as a doctor, I'm sure you've seen quite a number.
Definitely,
of that.
Yes. All and right. Even alcohol in itself has a lot of effects.
Effects on you.
Yeah. So you know, they. Can I say something?
Yes, please.
They look to me like they were high on weed rather than alcohol.
Oh, wow. And then... wow.
Like, bangy.
He has zero chills, Omar. Has zero chills for the guys there.
Yes,
but now that you brought the issue to do with weed, there's a guy who wants to legalize
weed.
The legalization of marijuana.
And that's what I wanted to say. I wanted to say that, you know, there are a number of Kenyans who act and talk as if they're already so high.
Yeah.
So I think we may not need to legalize weed. I think we have enough already. Yeah.
But he says that It can cure about, well, how many diseases did he say? He about said 670 something.
Of course.
678.
Personally, but I've never seen weed except the ones in pictures. So that's how much law-abiding I am.
I've never seen weed.
But I think, I think.
You're a law-abiding citizen.
Yeah, I think from a scientific perspective, and this is just from my own reading, I don't think weed is as bad as cigarettes.
Oh, really?
I mean, from a long-term effect. Okay. That's what I think. I could be very wrong, but that's what I think.
Okay.
Although I've never seen weed, so...
You have... He has never seen... And he keeps repeating that he has never seen weed. So. Okay, we get it.
Yeah, so...
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah, I think just to give a shout-out to my doctors.
Oh, yeah, you want to give a shout-out.
Great people.
There you have. Have your five seconds of...
Uh-huh. Yeah, and the splendid her. She's watching somewhere, so...
Who's
that? Splendid her, you know, my girl.
Your girlfriend?
Yes.
Splendid, that's her name?
No.
Oh, I thought she's splendid.
She's splendid.
She is splendid, and she's watching. I thought she was splendid, that's her name. Yeah. Splendid her. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much. Splendid.
Thank you.
Lady out there. Take care of him.
Yeah.
All right, so say goodnight to all viewers.
Good night, guys.
All right. Yeah. Dr. Omo Oluga has been our guest anchor. Yeah. He is the Secretary General of KMPDU. I can see there are very many people who are waiting for treatment. So I'll leave you to that. My name is Betty Kalo. Do have yourselves a lovely weekend. But be safe. Don't drink and drive.
And don't bangy and drive.
Whatever that means. All right, so see you next week. God bless you.
Thank you.
That was good. Thank you. Thank you.